Another office and white gaming PC incoming. Stay tuned.
Tell me, do you build? You will.
Hello everybody. This time I'm not going to upgrade and switch a few parts. It's completely new build for office PC, used mainly for coding, productivity and white gaming once in a while, mostly CSGO. Most of the parts are secondhand, except the CPU cooler and the case. I'll be using the same case as mine, it's InWin 101. Total price for the build is around $270, considering the case and the CPU cooler cost me around $100. The motherboard is P7P55LX from Asus. This chipset unfortunately does not support USB 3, so I had to buy this PCI Express card from eBay for $5. And the best part is that it has USB 3 header for the front USB ports on the case. As you can see, the CPU is already installed on the motherboard. It's a Xeon X3450. Originally it costs around $9, but I got it for $6 shipped from AliExpress with the $3 discount. The CPU is overclockable by the base clock, so I'm doing that as well later on. The cooler is from Arctic, it's eSports 34 Duo, and as far as I researched, it has similar or even slightly better results than the Hyper 212 Evo. We've got 16 gigs of memory, it cost me $22 shipped. The graphics card, oh my, it's a Radeon HD 5870 from Sapphire. I had to stay late yesterday to clean it. It took me around an hour and a half do it while filming, so you can check the video if you're interested. The power supply is a CX600 from Corsair. It has 80 plus bronze certificate. It's not the greatest power supply, but it will do the job. For backup plan, I've got RM650X, also from Corsair. The SSD is Samsung Evo 840 with 250 gigs for the OS, and for storage I will add a 3.5 inch hard drive, though we also have a NAS server in the office. I have only two LED case fans. I've ordered like 20 from these from AliExpress and I'm expecting them to arrive in the next month or so. Some sleeve cables and heat sinks from the memory. And that's all. Let's build this and then we'll play a little bit with the overclocking.
Adding the heatsinks on the memory is quite easy. If you're interested in a full video demonstration, let me know in the comments. Sometimes I spread the thermal paste over the IHS, but most of the time this is enough. Installing this cooler is quite easy. You have to add the standoffs first on the motherboard, and then put the cooler and tighten the screws to the standoffs. And here comes the hard part, installing the memory. The very first thing you put inside the case should be the IO shield, and try not to cut yourself. Taken off, the side panel of the case is done by removing those two thumb screws. Take the front panel cables and place them inside the case. Unfortunately, this was the HD audio cable for the front ports. I had to reroute it from a different place. It's too thick. Now it's better. Let's screw just a few of the screws in case I need to change something again. Oh yeah, these screws are so tight. I'm going to use the Molex cable for the case fans, otherwise with the tripping header there isn't enough voltage to power the LED lights. Yeah, it would have been easier if I installed the fan after I plugged the cable. And this is the longest and the most boring stuff when building a PC. Routing the cables can be a pain in the ass sometimes.
So, I had a few problems. The first one is about the cable management. It's almost next to impossible to cable manage it the way I want to manage it. Also, I need this long SATA cable for the hard drive because mine is short and I had to go to buy one. And the second problem was the display port of the graphics card. It was not working. I panicked at the beginning why it's not working. And I had to try HDMI and DVI, and it's working as expected, so I will stick with HDMI for now. I will play a little bit with the overclocking right now, and after that I will shot some B-roll footage, and that's all. Thank you for watching and subscribe to the channel. Bye!
You suck!
Every time I build a PC, the office looks like this.